Hello everyone, I welcome you here to the Gyanashree classes. So in this video we'll discuss about the unit 10 for paper 1 higher education, and in this video I'll cover all the three tests. Basically this unit is based on the facts and figures only, old data, new data and current data, all of these things are included. So it is basically consisting of less application based questions. So here we start. First question, during which year the present system of affiliation of colleges to the universities was introduced in India? So it was introduced in 1857. Next question, which one of the following is an educational FM radio network? So it is Gyanvani, jo ki IGNU ka hai. Next question, the Constitution of India provides right to establish educational institutes of their choice by all minority as per the article, that is as per the article number 31. Next question, Swayam refers to, so it refers to study waves of active learning for young aspiring minds. So the answer is B. Next question, which one of the following reports address the academic, technical and administrative problems of the examination system? So it was addressed in the report on standard of educational system, that is 1965. Next question, in the institutions of higher education in India, which of the following has the formal authority to approve the courses and programs of studies? So it is done by the Academic Council. Next question, for pursuing a PhD program through our university system, what has become a mandatory provision now? So the mandatory provision is coursework. Next question, to improve access and equality in teacher in higher education, the Knowledge Commission recommendations include which of the following? So they include your use of ICT for production of knowledge, yes. Closure of non-performing universities in the country, no. Establishment of a network of institutions of higher learning, yes. Increase in the enrollment of students in the institutions of higher learning, yes. So the answer is A, C and D. B is not included. Next question, India has the largest higher education system in the world after. So it is after the United States of America and after China. So the answer is A and C only. Next question, Prime Minister Research Fellowship is for students pursuing PhD program in, so it is for IIT and IISc students, IITs and IISc students. Next question, leader of the opposition is a member of committees which select the Central Information Commissioner, Central Information Commissioner, yes. The Central Vigilance Commissioner, yes. The chairperson of National Human Rights Commission, yes. Only these three are included. So the answer is A, B and C only. Next question, which of the following statements are correct about gender budgeting? So it separates budget addressing the specific needs of women, no. It assesses the impact of government budget on women, yes. It is an accounting exercise, no. It is another budgeting innovation, yes. So the answer is B and D only. Next question, which of the following are the barriers to citizen-centric administration in India? So the barriers are wooden and inflexible attitude of the civil servants, yes. Ineffective implementation of laws and rules, yes. Awareness of rights and duties of the citizens, this is not a barrier. Lack of job opportunities for the youth, this is also not a barrier. So the answer is A and B only. Next question, which of the following universities has received the Visitors Award for the Best Central University in India in 2017? So it is Jawaharlal Nehru University, JNU. Next question, which of the following comes with the ambit of the term corruption? So misuse of official position, yes. Deviation from rules, laws and norms, yes. Non-action when action is required, yes. Harm to public good, yes. So the answer is A, B and C, D. All are the responsible terms. Okay, next question, who among the following can be removed by the president without parliament's resolution? So it is governor of a state, which can be removed by the president without parliament's and resolution. Next question, which of the following are the goals of higher education in India? So goals are access bhi hai, equity bhi hai, quality and excellence bhi hai, relevance bhi hai, value based education bhi hai, compulsory and free education hai. Okay, So the answer, compulsory free education is for primary education, higher education. The answer is A, B, C, D, E. Next question. Which of the following has been ranked the best college in the country 2020 as per the National Institutional Ranking Framework, NIRF? So it is Miranda College, Delhi. Miranda House, Delhi. So the answer is second. Next question. Which of the following are the demerits of globalization of higher education? So demerits are your exposure to global curriculum, no. Promotion of elitism in education, yes. Commodification of higher education, yes. Increase in the cost of education, yes. So the answer is B, C and D. This is the answer. B, C and D. B, C and D. Next question. Which of the following statements are correct about deemed universities? So correct statements are the governor of the state is the chancellor of deemed university, no. They can design their own syllabus and coursework, yes. They can frame their own guidelines regarding admission and fees, yes. They can grant degrees, yes. So the answer is B, C, D. Next question. Test number 2. Educational health values include, so it includes schools should have a first aid box, yes. Medical inspection of the students, yes. Ventilation in schools, yes. So the answer is all of the above. Next question. Patriotic values are included under the groups of, so they are included under the groups of social values. Next question. The headquarter of Mahatma Gandhi Antarashtri Hindi Vishwavidyalaya situated in, which is situated in Wardha. Next question. The period of Indian education system, Indian Education Commission was, so it is from 64 to 66, that is Kothari Commission also. Next, the first Indian satellite for serving the educational sector is known as, so it is known as EduSat. Next question. Value education should help in, so it should help in eliminating violation fantasism. Next question. IGNU stands significantly apart from other universities because of national jurisdiction, yes. Flexible admission rules, yes. Student support services, yes. So the answer is all of the above. Next question. Who among the following gave particular attention to establishment of comprehensive institutions for the rural people starting at the early childhood level going up to the highest? So it was given by both Mahatma Gandhi and Rabindranath Tagore. So the answer is both A and B. Next question. IGNU came into existence in, so it came into existence in September 1985. Next question. The NPE 1986 recommended for, so it recommended for reorganization of education. Next question. Which of the following was not considered in the recommendation of NPE 1986? So training of graduates was not considered in the recommendation of NPE 1986. Next question. Approach towards education should be, so it should be investment in human resources. When we will invest, only then we'll get the output. So it should be investment in human resources. Next, many individuals accept employment in educational fields because of their zeal for imparting knowledge. Next question. Which of the following is not situated in New Delhi? So Indian Institute of Advanced Studies, it is not in New Delhi, it is in Shimla. So the answer is D. Next question. In higher education, students are better motivated through, so they are better motivated through personal achievements. Next question. The most important factor in teaching in higher education is to lead students to the sources of information. It is the important factor in teaching of higher education. So the answer is lead students to the source of information. Next question. National Council for Women's Education was established in, so it was established in 1958. Next question. Extension education is understood as, so it is understood as education meant to spread knowledge among villagers. Next question. Curriculum planning is a part of, so curriculum planning is the part of educational management. Next question. Which one of the following is not the tool of good governance? So judicial activism is not the tool of good governance. Next question. Test number 3. Which of the following statements are correct about the Central Information Commission? So the correct statements are the Central Information Commission is a statutory body, yes. The Chief Information Commissioner and other information commissioners are appointed by the President of India, yes. The commission can impose a penalty up to a maximum of rupees 25,000, yes. It can punish an errant officer, no. So the answer is 1, 2 and 3. Next question. Which one of the following councils have been disbanded in 2013? So that is Distance Educational Council, DEC. Next question. The first virtual university of India came up in, so it came up in Tamil Nadu. Next question. Which one of the following statements is not correct about the University Grant Commission? So it was established in 1956 by an act of parliament. Yes. It is tasked with promoting and coordinating higher education. Yes. It receives planned and non-planned funds for the central development. Yes. It receives funds from state governments in respect of state universities. No. So this is not the correct statement about UGC. Next question. In which of the following categories the enrollment of students is higher in 2010 to 11 was beyond the percentage of seats reserved? So it is OBC students. Next question. Which of the following organization deals with capacity building program on educational planning? So NUPA deals with it. Next question. Which of the following universities has adopted the meta-university concept? So, Delhi University has adopted the meta-university concept. Next question. Which of the following are central universities? So, Pondicherry is the central university, Vishwa Bharati is the central university, and HNB Grewal is the central university. Kurukshetra is not the central university. So, the answer is 1, 2, and 3. Next question. Answer is 1, 2, and 3. Next question. Education as a subject of legislation figures in the, so it is in the concurrent list. That is, it is the responsibility of both state and central government. Next question. Which of the following are the objectives of Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan RUSA? So, first, to improve the overall quality of state institutions, yes. To ensure adequate availability of quality faculty, yes. To create new institutions through upgradation of existing autonomous colleges, yes. To downgrade universities with poor infrastructure into autonomous colleges? No. So the answer is A, B, and C only. Next question. A, B, and C only. Next question. The University Grant Commission was established with which of the following aims? So following are the aims. Promotion of research and development in higher education, yes. Identifying and sustaining institutions of potential learning, yes. Capacity building of teachers, yes. Providing autonomy to each and every higher educational institutions in India. No, this is not the function of UGC. So the answer is A, B, C and A, B, C only, okay. ABC. Next question. Assertion: the purpose of higher education is to promote critical and creative thinking abilities among students. Reason is these abilities ensure job placements. Both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A because zaruri nahi hai ki jitne bhi jiske bhi paas critical and creative thinking abilities hain to unka job placement jo hai wo ensure hi hota. It is not possible. So it is not the correct reason. Next question. Which of the following core value among the institution of higher education are promoted by NEC? So we have following core values. Which of the following core value among the institutions of higher education are promoted by the NEC? So we have contributing to national development, yes. Fostering global competencies among the students, yes. Inculcating a value system among students, yes. Promoting the optimum utilization of the infrastructure? No. This is not the responsibility for NEC. So the answer is A, B, and C only. Next question. A, B, and C only. Next question. Which of the following statements are correct in respect of Niti Aayog? It is a constitutional body? No. It is a statutory body? No. It is neither a constitutional nor a statutory body? Yes. It is a think tank policy? Yes. So the answer is C and D only. Next question. The purpose of value education is best served by focusing on, so it is best served by focusing on concern for human values. Next question. Which of the following statements are correct about deemed universities? So for deemed universities, we have the governor of the state is the chancellor of deemed university. No. They can design their own syllabus and coursework. Yes. They can frame their own guidelines regarding admission and fees. Yes. They can grant degrees. Yes. So the answer is B, C and D. Next question. Which of the following are the demerits of globalization of higher education? So demerits are exposure to global curriculum. No. Promotion of elitism in education. Yes. Commodification of higher education. Yes. Increase in the cost of education. Yes. So the answer is B, C and D. Next question. Indian Institute of Advanced Studies situated at, so it is situated at Shimla. So B is the answer. Next question. NCTE as a statutory body functions under, so it functions under MHRD. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सेल्फ स्टाइल्ड अनरिकॉग्नाइज्ड यूनिवर्सिटीज आर टर्म्ड एज, सो दे आर टर्म्ड एज फेक यूनिवर्सिटीज बिकॉज दे आर अनरिकॉग्नाइज्ड यूनिवर्सिटीज. सो हियर वी कम टू एन एंड फॉर यूनिट नंबर 10. सो हियर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर टेस्ट सीरीज फॉर पेपर 1. सून आई विल बी गिविंग वीडियो फॉर द टेस्ट सीरीज फॉर द यूनिट 10 फॉर पेपर 2. सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टेस्ट सीरीज. सो टेक केयर ऑफ योरसेल्फ्स, प्रिपेयर वेल फॉर द इल्स, स्टे हेल्दी, स्टे सेफ एंड बाय.